Nobody should project me as chief minister. I will lead the new political revolution in the country. That is superstar Rajinikanth, while saying that he's still a small player in the larger scheme of things, addressing that press conference. He has, in a certain sense, laid out the roadmap for his political party. Sam Daniels, tracking the details of the story, joining us on the phone line. Sam, break it down for us. Rajinikanth there announcing his political foray. What all has he said?
Well, it's still not very clear whether he is entering politics or not. That is still not clear. But he says there need to be a fundamental change, a revolution in the country. And he says he has three plans in mind. One, to bring lots of youngsters, because the present system, he says, has lots of people above 50, above 60, not allowing youngsters to come in. Right? So he wants to bring in lots of people under 40. Secondly, he also wants to knock at the doors of many retired bureaucrats, police officers, known for their integrity and waiting for a chance to contribute to politics. He wants to knock at the doors so that they'll be able to join. Thirdly, he says he wants to distinguish between political party and the bureaucratic setup or the governance setup. He compares it to the present system where the same person heads the party and the government and nobody is held accountable, whereas he would want to demarcate these two, make it clear that these two are separate entities. One's job is to implement whatever was promised, and the other's job is to ensure that whatever was promised would be implemented. And he wants his supporters, his district secretaries, his followers to take this message to the nook and corner of Tamil Nadu to get a sense of what people have to say about that. He says if there is no change of government, if there is no change of rule now in Tamil Nadu, it will be never. And he says he is placed in between two giants. One, the ruling AIADMK, which has been in power close to 10 years and which wants to continue that. On the other side, he says he's facing the DMK. He doesn't name these parties, but he says the other side is waiting to grab power after 8 years, after the legendary terminology. And he calls himself as a small speck, and he only wants to be to play the role of a bridge to facilitate the kind of vision he has in mind. And the larger point is, he is not saying whether he is entering politics or not, but he is only emphasizing that there is a need for a new change of government, an alternate form of governance, and he wants his followers, his supporters, to take that message. And he also clarified what was the disappointment he experienced during the last meeting last week with his district secretaries of the Rajini People's Forum, when he narrated this like story to them, saying that he doesn't have plans to become the chief minister. He wants to have the model where these two entities will be completely different. Many said they will not be fans and people may not be willing to follow him if he has kind of a model in mind. And it was that came as a huge disappointment to him, as we said. But he has said he is not going away. That's the kind of ambiguity he has left with.
Right.
That he is not isolating himself. But he has now given the task for his secretaries, for his followers, to take his message of his model to the movement of Tamil Nadu, asking to bring about a kind of a people's revolution, without
right.
which he says they cannot be a change
Sam,
of government.
I do want to, since of course you were live translating that entire press conference for us, I have to ask you, he said that the time for political change is now or never. He's added that he opposes a one-man rule. There should be dual leadership. He's talked about, infusing young blood in politics. But he has stopped short in a certain sense of making any big announcement or laying out, a sort of a roadmap or a chronology of events as to how, his political ambitions are going to unfold.
That's right. What he appears to be making is this model of governance, his model of political leadership is acceptable to the people, to the common man. If that is visible in the form of a kind of an uprising or a revolution, then he hints that he'll be able to enter politics. He's neither saying yes for political entry, no for political entry, but he has given a kind of a challenge to his followers to test the pulse of the people. Perhaps that could be interpreted as the answer for his larger question of political entry.
Right.
But at the moment, Rajni has not said he is quitting politics. He doesn't say he's entering politics. He has placed before people his model of politics.
Okay, so he's placed essentially a model, stopped short of making an announcement in terms of this being his big entry or his foray into politics. Keep tracking the story, Sam. A lot to read between the lines there in that press conference. We'll come back to you for more updates on that big story.